The new version of Procreate is here, and in this video, I'm going to show you all the new additions. The main change in 5.4 is the brush library. If you know the work of Kyle T. Webster, a legendary brush maker, you'll be happy to hear that he's joined Procreate to create 180 new brushes. So let's begin. Organizing the brush library. So now you can organize your brush library. If you click on the brush icon, you'll see your current library, but if you pinch a little bit, you will see that Procreate has created a second brush library. So there are 18 brush sets in here, and in each one you have 10 new brushes. So if you pinch a little bit, you will go back to the main menu and you can select your classic library or your Procreate library. So you can customize this brush library as you wish. So let me just make a duplicate just in case we don't mess on anything. I'm going to click and hold on the brush library and I'm going to say duplicate. So say that you want to customize your brushes. So what I'm going to do is to click on this, and let's say that I want all these 5 brushes on my classic library. So what I'm going to do is click on here, and once you can move your brush, you can click with your other hand all the brushes that you want, select and pinch, and you go to your classic library and drag it here. So now I have here on a new brush set my brush, so I can keep and add all the brushes that I love the most. Brush search. Before, when I couldn't find a brush, I will be scrolling up and down, and now if you drag a little bit your screen, you will see that there is a new search bar. So if I type in pastel, in this case, it will show me all my pastel brushes that I already have, and then the new brush sets. So Procreate library, you see, this is a new brush set. And if I click here, it will lead me to where this brush set is and all the brushes that are inside. Custom brush set icons. Now you can customize your brush set icons. So if you click here, here on customize icon, you can click and choose the icon that you want. There are a lot to choose from. And if you have an emoji on top of your title, you can tap here. And if you want to remove your brush icon, it will create your emoji as a icon. Brush backup in iCloud. You can now backup your brushes in the Files app. So go to the wrench icon, and here on preferences, you'll see that there is one new option that says store brushes in iCloud. And if you toggle this, it will say store brushes in iCloud, new brushes only, or all brushes. I would like to keep all my brushes, and so I'm going to tap here and it will move to my iCloud. So one way to see where these brushes are in the files here. And if you tap on iCloud, you will see that here on Procreate brushes, you have classic library and Procreate library, just the brushes that we have. So here you have all of them, and here you have the Procreate new brushes. So if you go in, you will see that you have all the brushes here available. So this is really helpful because until now we haven't had access to customize or save our brushes outside Procreate. And now we have this option, which is great. Brush Studio Additions. So if you like to create brushes, you love these new options in the Brush Studio. So if I go to my pastels, for example, and I click on Ravenswood, for example, it will take me to the Brush Studio. And here we have a few options that you can see that are new. I'm not a brush creator. I like to work more with the brushes that I have. But in case you are, let me walk you through some of them. Under Apple Pencil, for example, there's now a brush curve control that lets you map exactly where the pressure changes. So see, if you move that, it will create more pressure or less pressure depending on what you want. Under stroke path, you have now here two new additions, which is gyro lateral, you see, that moves your brush like this, and gyro linear. And now on about this brush, before we could edit the name of the brush, but here in the new version, it's not possible. I don't know if it's a glitch or is something they're going to change, just to be aware of that. And also on shape, you have these two new options, which is roundness, vertical jitter. You see that? It's amazing how cool this is. And roundness, horizontal jitter. And under rendering, you have a new option, which is the alpha threshold. If you toggle this, you have a new slider. And with this new slider, you can play with the brush transparency in more detail. And on the colors panel, now you have the look that has been a little bit changed. If you see, the corners are a little bit rounder. And this history of colors that we used, it's available in all the iPads. So not only on the iPad Pro, also in the small iPads. So let me show you some of the brushes that I loved most. So I think brush set that I loved the most was pastels, because I'm always looking for more texture on my illustrations. I think the texture is super, super nice. It looks really like a pastel brush because of how organic it is. I think all of these are really nice, really textured. You see, I have these two. And you have a lot of them, like with traditional painting, like oils, pastels, inks, design, paint. And on lettering, I have one that it's quite nice, which is White Awake. You see, that's really nice. And also you have new like Ravi Rose that combines two colors. Let me show you. So in this case, you have already two colors that are perfect for lettering or for your titles. And I think that's really nice. And one that I love a lot also is on oils, this olive. So let me show you how this behaves, because if you turn into a bigger brush stroke, look at this. And that's a look of the major updates in Procreate 5.4. Which is your favorite change? Let me know in the comments. I will definitely play with these brushes in the future, and I'm going to create some cute illustrations and show you in the process. So if you like this video, click subscribe to follow my art journey, and see you in the next one. Bye.